The dews of the evening most carefully shun those tears of the sky for the loss of the sun.
Shapeshifters. This happens to be a benefit for shapeshifters. We'll explain all that later. Okay? So it looks like we're going to start in about 2 minutes. Last call for beer right now. There'll be another call at intermission. I hope you all have a program and a raffle ticket. Okay? Is that all?
As you know, Shapeshifter Cinema is a microcinema in Oakland. It has its roots here at ATA. I spent a lot of time with Craig Baldwin learning the tricks of the trade. Kathleen Quillian and myself, I'm Gilbert Guerrero, we're the co-directors of Shapeshifter Cinema. We started in 2012 as a nomadic series focused on expanded cinema. We are fiscally sponsored by the San Francisco Cinematheque, so we do operate kind of a nonprofit project. And we also get a lot of grants, which we try to pay artists. We love highlighting all the work that's happening here in the Bay Area.
Are we going to be able to?
By expanded cinema artists.
People are going to be there.
Amazing to see you all here and be here. It's incredible.
Ellie, where's Ellie?
Just to kick off the show tonight, a few words, like, thank you for coming out. If you want to go donate to othercinema.com, put that donate button. I'll say one thing about the raffle, too, for folks who are in the house. You'll have some time to do that. Just put your name in the bucket at the door, and we're going to be raffling Shapeshifter Cinema t-shirt. The logo was was partially designed by me, but the lettering is all done by New Bohemia Science in San Francisco.
All right.
We also have a tote bag and pint glasses because we love beer.
Okay. All right. Gilbert, stay up here. I just want to kind of get, here's also Ellie, who kind of works with Shapeshifters a lot. Her piece is the anchor of the show tonight. So I just, in this introductory period here, I just wanted to be able to point to Gilbert and point to Ellie as principals in the program tonight. You'll meet them briefly later when we go on our little news bureau here, right? But this is just ad hoc right now for all you guys online. We just broke through. There's some major technical problems. So I thank you so much. Beg your pardon for all that, but we're online now, and thanks for your patience. We're going to start the show right now. So take a bow, Ellie and Gilbert, and I'll get on with the program. We'll talk to you later. All right. So, anyway, on with the show, and like I say, I appreciate everyone's patience, both online and in-house. That's Korla Pandit, you heard, for a trillion minutes there while we were getting ready. And I do believe we're ready to go with the Bryan. Is that correct that we're, Adam, on the Bryan Boyce? Okay, so we're going to go directly from Bryan Boyce, Gerard Ribera. I just want to say one thing about the Ribera is that this is a special pop-up during the month of May. And we took advantage of the fact of whatever, yellow tier, I think it's called, sorry, which means that masks are recommended, but we can have interior activities at half distance or something like that. So, you know, don't pile on top of each other, you guys, right now. So that's why we played with the idea of the masks so that we could pretend like we're at a mask ball, okay? So that's why we're always showing for these four shows during May, we're opening it with our little kind of logo, so to speak, called the Identity Parade. After that will be Kathleen Quillian's work. So actually, I will introduce those separately because they have to do with Shapeshifters. So on with these first two pieces. Thank you. Bye.
I must speak to you. Oh, just a minute, Melinda. Drew's escaped. Are you sure?
He escaped from the prison a couple of hours ago. We could hardly believe it.
Come with me, Kit.
Darling, do you think somebody could have helped Drew? I mean, with the costumes. That way, he could have been the pirate, Mandarin, anybody. Just by telling them he needed them for a joke.
It isn't a joke, Kat.
Drew!
My dear, a cavalier's costume is not too unusual.
But you planned all these horrible moments, didn't you? Planned them all before you killed me.
I could have killed you at any time tonight, quickly, very efficiently, but I wanted to watch your face when I killed you. I want you to watch my face. I want it to be the last image you see before you die.
Stop it! No!
I'm a married woman. You can't talk at all. Well, how else can I be except like I am?
Perhaps not.
Well, then I trust you won't mind my own.
But listen, it's not as bad as all that.
But one thing I do know, no one else could recognize me for the idiot I've been and still tolerate me.
We could have some fun.
How to...
Does it bother you?
No, I'm all right.
Yes, there has been a slight slip.
What? Did I ever pretend? Did I lie?
Are you afraid I'll embarrass you? Is that it?
There's nothing for you to be ashamed of either.
I just want you to be proud of me. You're too big and important for me.
Not your fault.
There's so much less of me now.
So much more of me now.
10 years ago, you wouldn't have spoken to me like that, William.
I beg your pardon?
Well, you have 2 feet and a mouth. Walk over and talk.
You know, you're not making any sense.
Really, Doctor, I think you know more about me than I know myself.
I don't know you. I imagine you don't know me either.
But I know you better than you know yourself.
You're making it up.
But I'm still your little girl, aren't I? I'm still me, aren't I?
Who cares about you? I'm thinking about me.
What are you talking about?
I'm not obliged to answer irresponsible questions. I advised against it.
Don't you really shouldn't. You shouldn't.
Are you afraid, John?
I'm not scared.
You sound scared.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
I wish you'd stop.
It's a living hell. I just can't do it. I can't do it.
I'd very much like to help you.
Take that filth off your face, Joe, like an American.
Three pieces are by Kathleen Quillian, my partner in crime, co-director of Shapeshifters Cinema. I actually did the sound for 2 of these pieces, the sound design. The pieces are Stardust Serenade, The Conjurer, and Confidence Game. I'll just say a little bit about Confidence Game. That was made in the era of our former president, whose name I won't say. And is an exploration of how persuasion can really influence the masses. Kathleen's an Oakland-based artist and has worked with collage and cut paper and animation.
Okay, thank you very much,
Joe, and
on with the show!
Let's show the pieces.
thrill of seeing that which has never been seen before. You're about to enter a beautiful, exciting, wonderful new world.
Your eyes will become tired, the lids heavy, and you will have great difficulty in keeping your eyes open. But you will not close your eyes until I command you to. Watch the stone now. Keep watching it, and you can feel its influence. It is quiet. It is warm. From head to foot, a heavy numbness comes over you, and a desire to sleep becomes stronger the longer I speak, and the sound of my voice and the influence of the hypnotic gem is slowly but very surely overcoming your conscious mind.
Thank you.
What's wrong?
There's a hex on our house.
Everyone has problems. Ribbit.
Maybe you can break it. I doubt it.
I'll try.
My name's Gluey.
I'll stick with you. Does your dog have rabies?
No, he gave them all away.
He looks like my car.
That's what they all say. I have to change.
Don't change! Phone call.
Oh! You can tell a dirty story in the old conservatory, but don't go in the basement. You can make a scene on the mezzanine, but don't go in the basement. You can fill yourself with static with ghosts up in the attic, but don't go in the basement. Light yourself a torch on the old front porch, but don't go in the basement. Or you may think that it's real cool to ride down the banister like some darn fool. Oh, don't go in the basement. Hey, feel quite aloof playing a rummy on the roof, but don't go in the basement. Cockroaches dance, you can wallow in romance, but don't go in the basement. Oh, you may think that is the last to ride in the elevator filled with us. Oh, don't go in the basement.
For what am I a nut?
And I'm not wearing underwear. My secret subway.
Where does it go?
To hell.
Oh no, can't go.
But it makes one stop in Miami, bitch. Hello, Max.
Thank you.
secure from all alarms, leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting
straight to the soul of man. The right hand, friends, the hand of love. Now watch and I'll show you the story of life. These fingers, dear hearts, is always a warring and a tugging, one against another. Now watch them. Oh, brother left hand. Left hand hates a fighting. And it looks like love's a goner. But wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hot dog, love's a winning. Yes, sirree. It's love that won. And old left hand hate is down for the count.
very collaborative.
A very collaborative piece.
It's a collaborative piece because we're doing things. Look at this. Hear that sound? You hear that sound coming through the, I'm talking through the ATA.
Don't
wow.
Stop it.
It's 16 millimeter film I composed years ago that Kit has taken with his camera and reprocessed, but we're producing images over that. So there's so many layers to this, but the deal is that my oscillating synthesizers are creating patterns that we sort of can control, but we really can't. And this is an homage that I kind of came up with as a concept because COVID pandemic, not to step on any toes, but everyone's washing and sanitizing and constantly not feeling clean and germs and this and that. So there's a limit. There's a limit that all I can't.
And that's enough.
That's enough. Thank you. Thank you for coming out to see me and all my family members.
Mysophobia.
Normal and usually harmless unless you have too many of them.
also known as demo decks, each mind has four pairs of legs that make it easy to grip tube-shaped things like her lashes. Demo decks minds are tiny eight-legged arachnids that make their home in the pores and hair follicles of your face. These critters crave oil, which make the edges of your eyelids prime real estate.
Germs can be killed. Germs can be killed with high temperature and fire. High temperature and fire.
I stepped on a nail in my bare feet yesterday. It hurts. I hope my tetanus shots are up to date. Sometimes, when I get too cold, I can't stop shivering, and my toes are like ice cubes.
house tidy. But when I looked at the rest of the tapes on the shelf, I saw many more crawling on the Magox I ribbon. I panicked. I pulled out my favorite Kenny Rogers record, and there were the same bugs crawling around, eating the cardboard cover. This made me feel very sick. It felt like I could wash those records. I ended up throwing all our precious home movies that meant so much to me away. I'll feel much better if I can wash my hands again.
oké, hamis más hangon énekelnek, főleg a monitorokat érdemes nézni, mert ott derül ki a csalafintaság, de úgy látják őket, ahogy sose hallották.
Televíziós Társaság hasbeszélő kórusát látták.
Bucket at the front.
Oh. Adam, it's a little hot.
I'm like yelling too, so maybe I don't need to yell. Wow, I'm mic'd. Yeah, $5. Put your name in the bucket, and we're gonna draw names out. Look at my beer. Oh. All right, are we ready? Okay, I guess we're. I want to say a couple things about Shapeshifters now that I've got the mic. Yeah. So I did tell you that we began in 2012 as a nomadic series dedicated to expanded cinema. We eventually took over our own venue, a whole building, this Victorian building that was built in 1872. It's in the Jack London district. And in 2019, at the end of that year, we actually started doing shows there. We had a few shows before we had to shut down in March of 2020. Actually, Tommy Becker is in the house. Where is he? There he is. He was booked to do a show in March, but we had to shut that one down. He was gracious enough to let us screen a show that he did for us during our nomadic-like screenings at the Temescal Arts Center. And Steve Heiss and John Leidecker, also known as Wobbly, pitched in. They actually brought in some work from Negative Land that we screened that night, I think. And then somehow we got in touch with Devo, and we screened like some of their videos that have been recently like transferred, and they looked awesome. So that was an incredible night, beginning of like a strange journey. Ellie, do you want to come up here for a sec too? I just want to give some appreciation here to Ellie Vanderlip, who joined Other Cinema early on, and then has become our workshops coordinator. Joined Shapeshifters. Did I say Other Cinema? I'm like, things are bleeding over now. Okay. Joined Shapeshifters early on. Something kind of interesting that happened during the shutdown for the pandemic is that we went online, we live streamed all sorts of work. There are several artists in the house here who've done live stream shows with us. Lori and Kit, whose work you just saw, thank you so much. How do I... oh. We did an awesome show with projection art, took over our space. Anne McGuire, who's in the house tonight, performed like an awesome piece in our space, was live recorded in our space as well. And then Carrie Lytle, who's also here tonight, has also screened work as part of a book release with Jonathan Wally on called Cinema Expanded. So go look for that. Did I miss anybody? Greta, yeah, Greta, where are you? Okay, there she is, okay. Greta has also been teaching like these amazing workshops with us. Ellie taught a material cinema workshop. They've all been online. We've had people from all over the world joining these workshops. We also have an online shop, so go there and buy stuff. We are working on opening our doors in June. We have a broadcast of a live performance on June 20th. We'll be screening a new piece by Guillermo Galindo in collaboration with the Living Earth Show. And that was shot in our space just recently. We're going to be broadcasting that. We're hoping to open our doors soon to have some kind of event around that. More to come on that. So just go to shapeshifterscinema.com to stay up to date on that stuff. Maybe you can help me with the raffle. We have a t-shirt, a tote bag, and a pint glass. So three lucky winners will be getting those. I guess they can take their pick. So come on up, take your pick. So take your pick of one. Or a pint glass.
Yeah, you go for the bag.
Yeah, okay. Awesome. All right. Oh. Those were the winners. Okay, down the hall. Okay. Is there a Zadie in the house?
Yeah, I brought her with. We had to go back. Yeah, we had to return her home. She's 9 years old, so we had to give her back.
Oh, yeah.
She's 9 years old.
It's all right. Yeah. Mark, come on up.
Go, go.
pint glass or a t-shirt. We have other sizes too. I can give you a different size if you want to.
Okay, if you get a 9, a 12, 9, I'll give you a smaller one.
Here, this, here, I got you right here.
He doesn't drink beer, so we can't give her this.
Actually, I got it. Oh, wait, where do they go? We do have smalls.
Perfect.
And I'm going to get it to you right now. Here we go.
Oh, chance
this should work. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Awesome. All right, we got one more for the pint glass.
Oh, that's right. the top.
JPM?
JPM, all right, awesome. And,
there you go. Thank you very much.
Yeah. All right, so on with the show.
All right, on with the show.
Oh,
pass away the mic. Pass away the mic.
Give me the mic.
Where is it? Oh.
Okay, hello.
Here comes Ellie's piece, and she's
yes.
going to introduce it right now.
This piece is called Ash Meadow. It's two 16mm projectors, one regular 8 projector, and some text that's projected digitally. The 16 is a recut of the 1972 like short documentary called John Muir's High Sierra, and the regular 8 is personal family footage of my dad's family in the 60s in the Bay Area. This film is about my grandmother's desire to have her ashes interned in the High Sierra window. So that's
what it's about. Wow!
Lights. Adam, I hope you get your own lights.
Sierra Nevada lay beneath the shallow arm of the Pacific Ocean. Slowly, through eons of sedimentation and uplift, it gradually rose above the waves. Then, 2 million years ago, came the Great Ice Age, and glaciers forming along the crest of the range spread out in all directions, covering the mountains with a crushing weight of ice. Four times the glaciers covered the Sierra. Once they were joined by the roar of earthquakes as the eastern edge of the range downfaulted, leaving a mountain wall above the Owens Valley of more than 2 miles. And when the glaciers had receded, and when the earthquakes had stopped, there lay along the eastern edge of California a mountain range stretching for over 400 miles, the longest, tallest single mountain range in the United States. It was dotted with glacial lakes, and at more than 12 points thrust itself over 14,000 feet above the sea. Finally culminating in the great summit of Mount Whitney.
The resources of Craig Baldwin, the archive, which is right beneath your feet right now, to make this film called Countdown. All right? So that will be the last of this huge pod, as we call it, before we come up for air, about 22 minutes. Okay? So we'll see you then. Bye.
Te ao mamo to ka kuhi hewa noho alii a oa. Ai anō he e hā mau kanaka tūpaya naha o ta holomoana. a haele mai lako mai moa ulanui a kea, a tū mai hawai ini. Nohoi uluko ma Waikiki. A oia mau malihini, heu I kanaka leo maliu. A he no nohe waipahe no nae. A ole he tāne, a ole he wahine. He mau māhū lāko. He pālua noho I lāko makana au, mika no onoo, a mana ano āpau. A o teinoa tā lāko wala kai, oi anō o ka pae māhū. He mau hiva hiva ana atua o ia mau tahuna lapa au. O ka puni mana nui. Nohi, wahanana I te pāpālua. O ka hāloa me tāna lā au tāhea. A o ka pae māhū o ka tau lā au. Waka ana mai no lākou I tō lākou ite me tō lākou na awao I nā kanaka o ia pai aina. A lawa pono tā lākou hana, hūka I ini e mahalo ia po e tahuna lapa au, me ka tutulu aku I kekahi mea hoʻomana o ia lākou. Te pō tāne lākou I nau e ai, wa ātotoa lākou makaimuki, he wahi taulana I te pohatukani. Nā ue aku me e hā maupohatu nunui, a hiti loa I Waikiki. A ulu mai kalā, waihua kula lāko I tālāko mana lapa au, me ta kanu puketai, I mau ti iho o mana, mā lalo te pohatu taitai. Hala noho o tei mahina, o ta haalele noia o ka pae māhu mā, a ohe loa e ho I hō mai. He mau sene tuli I moe ei a mau pohatu mā kahatei. Ahalateau, aloliloa no. Naluale yamo aukala no Kapaemahu. Nalohia me ua maupohatu, mahalalo o kahitahua hale kinipopo oloka. Oia ino, wawehe hou ia mai ia maupohatu eha, pēlā no o ta kulana mahu o ia mautahuna lapaau, i ho'onalo ia mataha i mo olelo mai, no Kapaemahu ma. Awe, mina mina no hoi. Aloha. Te oe maopopo I te mō au kala o ia maopo hatu. Ala ilo oe ike I tō lako o mana ola. Ola, ola, ola. E ola loa te mō olelo no Kapaemahu.
have a Long Island iced tea.
Thank you.
with the beer. So I'm the one that has to run up there and turn on that projector to show Ray Harryhausen's piece. He's my hero. And there could hardly be an animation show without Ray Harryhausen. Thank God. And if this is what remains, you know, from a film from 50 years ago, just torn to shreds. But I managed to save these 2 minutes of it. It's the best part, of course. The Beast from 2012 changed my mind, changed my life when I saw it, and that's the reason I'm here now talking to you guys, brothers and sisters. Thank you, Rary. Rary. All right, now, there we go. Davy Force will blow your mind. Is it animation? Who cares? The Chickening is coming up with 5 minutes, and then we're out, and stick around. Okay, thanks very much. Lori chirps up from the, there's no doubt about it. It's all about the show. Here we go! Okay, no, sorry. Please bring sound up. Please bring sound up. I don't get any sound. I'm not getting any audio. We'll go to slow-mo. Is there sound? You should be getting it. We should be getting it. We should be getting it. We should be getting it. We've done this a million times. We should be getting it. I'm maxed here. I'm maxed here. It looks like a silent film. All right, get ready with David. I don't know what's going on, man. It's a fuck up. Not the first one.
Chick, chick, chicken is my favorite food. I'll eat the wings
and I'll eat the breast.
Chick, chicken, it is the best.
Welcome to Chabay's Chicken World and Restaurant Resort. This is the largest fast food entertainment complex in North America, with a subterranean farm, a power plant, and the world's only magma-heated chicken blast fryer. Now, you be the new senior chief night manager. Now, does that sound like what you're looking for?
Well, that sounds fine to me.
Yuck, you call this a sandwich?
Yeah, I know.
Tastes like shit.
What about Tony?
What about me? Get back in the kitchen and make me a real sandwich before I give you a crack in the mouth, maybe straighten out your eyes.
Come and play with us, daddy.
Oh!
Forever and ever and ever and ever. Come and play with us, daddy. Forever and ever and ever.
Charmaine's Chicken World and Restaurant Resort is going completely insane!
Crazy days.
Never try Charmaine's.
We've got a big surprise coming to you.
Introducing our new and amazingly tasty volcanically activated extreme dipping sauce, The Shiny.
They'll love it.
Charmaine's Chicken World and Restaurant Resort with over 237 attractions in Mount Spalzy on Highway 272.
We'll blindfold the chicken with a tiny little band-aid, and then we just drown them in the spicy barbecue sauce and pluck all the tail feathers with a shop vac and a pair of surgical clamps.
Do you mind if I ask why you do that?
Alfonso, do you mind just keeping it down a bit? The big people are talking here. And other than that, no other problems. Oh, except the toilets sometimes receive volcanic pressure blasts that explode feces all over the walls of the bathroom, I'm afraid.
Pressure tank is located in room 237. So we gotta go into room 237 and take out the volcano sauce pressure tank.
Room 237?
Yeah, room 237. 237. Am I not speaking clearly? You just gotta go in there and distract that big crazy chicken so me and Tony can plant the explosives.
Who's Tony?
Who the fuck am I? Who the fuck are you, you green ass piece of shit?
Torrance, hello! How are you? Okay, would you like to try the new experimental sauce, the shiny volcano sauce?
I'm awfully glad you asked me that, Lloyd.
Well done, okay, listen up. We have a spicy, a super spicy, tasty spicy. We have a super shiny spicy, and we have a super duper shiny spicy suicide sauce! Hey! It has the essence of a real natural volcano right in the inside of the
red rum! Red rum.
Oh, sorry, I meant burger. I'm dyslexic, didn't I tell you?
Okay, check.
Ever since we've moved here, you've been acting more and more like a chicken. It's too much pressure. The volcano sauce pipes is gonna blow.
A new twist on a classic tale of horror, The Chickening, rated R.